ask London Underground to show off their very best and they'll show you Heathrow Terminal 4, little over 2 years old. They claim it's the safest in the world with emergency exits, smoke sensors and fire shutters. Proof, they say, that given the money, London Underground is as safety conscious as any metro anywhere. But it's a one-off. 42 of the 43 stations bounded by the Circle Line were built between 50 and 125 years ago, and it's hard to make design improvements 80 feet below ground. This year, the Underground is spending around £30 million on upgrading the system. Over the next 3 years, they plan to spend a further £110 million. But no amount of money could re-engineer every station to the standard of Terminal 4. One of the main targets following the disaster is the wooden panelling on the old escalators, which caught fire with such dramatic effect. Tonight, there are 70 wooden escalators left on the tube network. 11 have been replaced since the fire. London Underground hope to get rid of them all by the middle of next year, as the Fennell report recommends. Fire detection and alarm systems have already been installed, and it's planned to have automatic sprinklers. Machine rooms beneath the escalators are being equipped with smoke detectors, and new security measures are being taken to stop unauthorised people getting into the rooms. The Fennell report calls for an urgent review of the Underground's new ticket barriers. They were designed to free Underground staff of platform and station duty, but have attracted hostility from passengers and transport watchdogs who say they're death traps. London Underground have insisted they're safe. Smoking and litter control has been another area of concern. Despite the haphazard appearance of many stations, London Underground say new measures have been introduced, including strict enforcement of the smoking ban. There are 3,000 new litter bins and special arrangements at major stations for frequent cleaning. But still, complaints continue. As a matter of policy, the fire brigade now attend every tube fire, and now new equipment's being brought in earlier than planned after a major review. Following King's Cross, firefighters complained of inadequate equipment and poor communication. They said protective gloves melted in the heat and radios were unreliable. These are the new uniforms that give more protection, show up better in the dark. There's breathing apparatus with an hour's supply of oxygen, radios linking directly with commanding officers, portable lighting and hydraulic cutting equipment.